who fills us with joy, peace and holiness on this feast. To the Good One be glory and honor on this feast and all the days of our lives and forever.
Amen.
Glory and thanks to you, Eternal Son. You are without beginning or end. You are the hidden light who shines upon the world in the Ancient of Days. Born as a child from the daughter of David, today we celebrate the mystery of your love for us, proclaiming, you are wonderful, O God. You became yet you are still God. You are wonderful, O God. You came down to us and were born in a manger, yet you filled heaven and earth with your glory. You are wonderful, O God. The angels, shepherds, and magi come to adore you. By your birth, you tore down the walls separating heavenly and earthly beings, reconciling heaven and earth. By your birth, you brought together those who are far and those who are near to celebrate your feast. At your birth, the angels announced to the shepherds, to you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah of the Lord. Now, O wondrous child, we ask you, with the fragrance of this incense, to help us to understand the mystery of your incarnation. Forgive our sins, free us from all distress, and remember our departed who have gone to the rest hoping in you. We raise glory and thanks to you, to your Father and your Holy Spirit, forever.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Bringing us closer to the one who dwells in the heights. With the light of your knowledge, you enlighten your minds with the knowledge of the one who is beyond our understanding. Accept our incense, forgive our sins, and grant rest to our departed. We raise glory and thanks to you, to your Father, and to your Holy Spirit, forever.
Father, and he will be my son. And again, when he brings the firstborn into the world, he says, "Let all God's angels worship him." Of the angels, he says, "He makes his angels winds and his servants flames of fire." But of the Son, he says, "Your throne, O God, is forever and ever, and the righteous scepter is the scepter of your kingdom. You have loved righteousness and hated wickedness. Therefore, God, your God, has anointed you with the oil of gladness beyond your companions. And in the beginning, Lord, you founded the earth, and the heavens are the work of your hands. They will perish, but you remain. They will all wear out like clothing. Like a cloak, you will roll them up, and like clothing, they will be changed. But you are the same, and your years will never end."
Praise be to God.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
From the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to St. Luke, who proclaimed life to the world, let us listen to the proclamation of life and salvation for our souls.
Remain silent, O listeners, for the Holy Gospel is about to be proclaimed to you. Listen and give glory and thanks to the Word of the living God.
The evangelist writes, "In those days a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judah, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house, the family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. In that region there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to him, 'Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You'll find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger.' And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, 'Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors.' When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, 'Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us.' So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherd told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told to them. This is the truth, peace be with you.
And their emotions and their feelings are how much money they can make.
or mention how much money will be given to them or spent on them. And I'm not going to attack that in any negative way. It's the reality that we live in. It's a scrambled mess and chaos. It isn't perfect. It's not a perfect season. And that, I don't say that as a downer either. I mean, I don't feel sad and depressed about this in particular. Because there's another thought that must be entered into our mind. That the season of Jesus does not come to an end. It isn't over. Maybe the Christmas tree will be out on the curb on the 26th or the 25th at the end of the day. Maybe all of those things that we joke about might happen. The kids are playing with the box instead of the toy again. That's all right. And you know what's good about this? Is that it, deep down as we mature and as we grow in the Lord, that it's not about just this particular day. The season does not end. Long ago when I was ordained a priest, well, not long ago, but kind of, sort of, I thought, you know, how a priest do you really celebrate Christmas when it is a work day? And the stress and anxiety that goes with it. Now, I'm not claiming that you don't have it too, but it's different. That I always watch throughout the season of announcement what will touch my heart in a spiritual way, in a powerful way, that will carry me through this season into the next with the abiding love of God. As I was driving to Sam's Club to get things that I should have done sooner, but I didn't, I started to think more and more about the song, Silent Night. And I sang it the way I used to hear it in one of the churches that I served in Indianapolis. It was a all-black parish. And they sung it in this spiritual way that you could feel the very depths of their soul. And that's exactly what sometimes we need, I know I do, that we really, really need sometimes a silent night, one that's holy, one that's not cluttered with all the chaos that's around us. It's kind of like a prayer for parents with young children that they'll fall asleep quickly and stay asleep. At least not wake up until after Santa's had the cookies in the milk. But the Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the first human in all creation, got to hold her baby. Wasn't in a beautiful place. There probably was a smelly place with all those animals there. But sometimes that's like our own life. Sometimes it smells a little bit. But a radiant light shines in the darkness. That whatever your tears may have been over the year, and who you may have lost that you have loved with all your heart, there's a feeling of emptiness, but we have a God that fills. Maybe there have been moments of depression in despair, in your own life or in someone else's life close to you, but there is a message of hope. That maybe this sensor breaks, but there's another one that's brought out to you. It's not as good as the other one, though. Just being honest, it doesn't have bells. But that's our humanity. What is your humanity? What are your weaknesses? What's running around in your mind and in your heart? And this is what I offer to you. I know someone. His name is Jesus. And through everything and anything, if we walk with him, we'll have the strength we need. We can go with the grace of God from disappointment to realizing that what really matters is our ability to love through everything. And if that is any prayer that I have for you and a prayer for me, is that I am reminded of that and I remind myself of that. To push everything to the side. I want you to find peace. I want you to know how much you're loved by God. That all these worldly things and the worldly season at this time, that's not forever. That's not what fulfills. That's not what's going to bring peace of mind as we go through life. Glory to God in the highest. Hallelujah. I hope something that you heard today in song or prayer will be with you. And it doesn't have to happen right this second, but you're on your way. I believe in Bethlehem, the place of bread. I believe that it's worth it to get back up, brush the grime and dust off, whatever kind it might be. I know that there is someone that has been held in a way that's never held God, to be kissed, to be nurtured, to be wrapped in swaddling clothes, to mix with us, to walk with us, to be with us, to give us courage and strength. Oh, Heavenly Father, we thank you for this precious gift. In a special way, Lord, I ask you to come into the heart of the person who's grieving the most here, the one that feels the most confusion and the most pain. Be with that mother who's at her wit's end, or that husband that's worried about his job. Be with that child who seems confused and seems to somehow think that for some reason he can't or she can't be loved. Be with us, Lord. Guide us into the next year. Don't let this season end because we need you each and every day. Walk with us. Be with us. Listen to us as we pour ourselves out to you, to this little baby in a crib, Jesus Christ, our Lord and God. send light into our darkness, you have given us hope. Let us profess our faith on page 748 or off the screen or by heart. We believe
in one God, Father Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father.
We call upon this offering all those who please God command to this day, especially Mary, the Blessed Mother of God, St. Mary, St. Joseph, and St. Jude. Remember, O God, the children of the Holy Church, our fathers and mothers, and our brothers and sisters, both the living and the departed, especially those for whom this sacrifice is offered, for the living and the deceased members of St. Joseph's and their families. Remember also those who share with us today in this offering.
Amen.
Again and again, we thank you, O Lord, and grace. forgiven us your body to eat your living blood to drink. O Lord,